Hello, I'm Pastor Donald H. Butler, and this is Yolanda Butler, and we are the pastors of Praise Center Community Church, and we just want to wish you a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Revelation 14:6, and I saw another angel fly in the midst of heaven, having the everlasting gospel to preach unto them who dwell on the earth, and to every nation, and kindred, and tongue, and people, saying with a loud voice, fear God, and give glory to him, for the hour of his judgment is come, and worship him that made heaven, and the earth, and the sea, and the fountains of the waters.
Somebody and getting high all the time, and God starts cleaning you up. Even if it makes me mad, God, tell me the truth. I don't like nobody to play around with me and lie to me. Hello, somebody, and neither should you.
And traces of discouragement and peace you cannot find.
Praise the Lord. This is Pastor Ernest Johnson welcoming you, or should I say Bishop Ernest Johnson, welcoming you to another anointed, appointed, and approved by God broadcast of Jesus is the Answer. We have such a power-packed broadcast for you today. We're going to hear a special choir selection from the Praise Center Community Church Choir, and I'm telling you, they are off the hook. They're going to share some Christmas carols with you, and we're going to have another special soloist who's going to be on the broadcast today, and in addition to that, we're going to share an anointed word with you. That's an order. Amen. The Bible says that the steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord. So I want you to know that your steps are ordered by God. So God is ordering you to repent. He's ordering you to take Jesus as your Lord and Savior. He's ordering you to be healed. He's ordering you to be delivered from drugs and from alcohol and from homosexuality and from your promiscuous life. God is commanding you to be set free. So we know that you're going to enjoy this anointed broadcast today. Let's go to this important message. And when we come back, amen, we'll take you into the World Television Center to see these great choirs and great soloists and the anointed word, that's an order. All right? We'll be right back right after this. Praise the Lord. This is Pastor Ernest Johnson, and I have with me the Praise Center Community Choir. And we all together want to wish you a very
Merry Christmas.
God bless you.
5.
My name is Kevin. I'm the director here.
And then
that's what I want to be.
And you know your line, right?
All right, action. I want to make big movies. So I split that. That feeling keeps me to want to go on and on. Get the camera, just film, think of
Bill,
something.
Bill, you think your results will be better?
All right, that was good. I know what I'm trying to do. If drugs get in the way, it's going to keep me from going where I want to go.
3.
I could be cool without smoking pot. Just keep something positive in my mind. Keep going straight, full speed.
Well, praise the Lord. Welcome back to the broadcast of Jesus is the Answer. I know that you enjoyed that message. Let's give the winds a mighty blow. Jesus saves. Jesus heals. Jesus is coming back again. Now let's go into the sanctuary of the Jesus is the Answer Praise Center, World Television Center, as we share the message with you. That's and order. And amen. And also, we're going to share this anointed choir with you, the Praise Center Community Church Choir. And I'm telling you, they're off the hook. They're going to share, amen, a praise medley with you and some Christmas songs. I know that you're going to be blessed. It's going to get you in the season. So get around your fireplace. Get all cuddly and warm. Amen. And enjoy this Christmas special with Jesus is the Answer. Come on. Let's go into the World Television Center. Amen. And I'll be back at the end of the broadcast with some important information. Merry Christmas. And have a happy new year as we go into the World Television Center.
Come on, put your hands together, put your hands together.
I want you to turn to your neighbor and say, neighbor, you to be blessed. Turn to somebody else and say, neighbor, I order you to be blessed in the name of Jesus. Some of y'all didn't get that, because if you were, you would have gone to praise. You would break down into praise right now. I order you to be blessed. I order you to have victory. I order you, how the devotion to overcome the work of the enemy. I order you, how the devotion to come to the mercy to be blessed. Go to the book of Psalms 1, chapter 133. Psalms 133. Amen. When you have it, say amen. 133. Oh my God, I feel the anointing in this place. Amen. 133. When you have it, say amen. Amen. And in, we're going to go to verse 3. 133, verse 3. As the dew of Hermon, and as the dew that descendeth upon the mountain of Zion, for there the Lord commanded the blessing, even life forevermore. Can we say amen? Amen. Turn to your neighbor again and say, neighbor, that's an order that you be blessed. That's our subtopic. You may take your seats. As God was speaking to me, amen, as Brother Herbert was sharing some word with me, see, sometimes when folks start speaking the word, God starts to give me revelation, amen. He starts to speak to me, and he starts to reveal things to me, amen, from the word of God. And when anybody knows anything about Pastor Johnson or Bishop Johnson, they know that I am a revelatory preacher. In other words, amen, I can study and study and study, and the Bible says study to show thyself approved unto God, a workman that needeth not to be ashamed. And I will study, and I will study hard, amen, and I will give you the depth of the word of God. But how many know that God will reveal his truth to you? He will reveal the word to you. Amen. He's a God of revelation. Tell somebody he's a God of revelation. Amen. The Bible says the Greeks seek after wisdom. In other words, some folk, amen, those in the Greek and the Hebrew text trying to get an understanding, but it's the Holy Ghost that will give you wisdom and knowledge. Come on, somebody. God will reveal himself to you in the scripture. And that's why Jesus said, search the scriptures, for in them ye think ye have eternal life. But they are they which testify of me. You got to come down on these monitors. Hallelujah. So Jesus said that I'm a God of revelation. Hello, somebody. He will reveal himself to you in the word. If you want to know Jesus, you need to get into his word. If you want to know something about him, you need to get into his word. If you want to know who he is and know everything about him, you need to get into his word. Because Jesus said the scriptures testify of me. Can I get a witness in here? And so in the scriptures here, amen, in Psalms 37:23, amen, he made the simple statement that the steps of a what kind of man? Amen. God is not ordering the steps of an evil man, and God is not ordering the steps of a sinner. Come on, somebody. God is ordering the steps of, amen, a righteous man. Hallelujah. You see, and I began to ask God, I said, why is it that you can order the steps of a righteous man, but not order the steps of an unrighteous man? He said, because an unrighteous man is not subject, amen, to my spirit. He is not subject to the word of God. He is not subject to the law of God. Hello, somebody. And so therefore, the Lord began to tell me that even though you go to church, it does not mean that you are subject to his will. Amen. Just because you sit here every Sunday, day in and day out, it does not mean that you are subject, amen, to his will and to his way. And I said, God, how do you know? He said, there are those that the scripture says that they that are of God hear God's voice, and they that are of God hear you, because you speak in God's name. Amen. If you are saved, folk that are saved are going to hear you, and folk that are obedient are going to hear you. Hello, somebody. But folk that are out of God's will are not going to hear you and not going to obey you. Amen. When you're speaking the truth of God's word. Can I get a witness in here? But the Bible says the steps of a good man are ordered. And the only word he began to tell me is, this is an order. Hallelujah. I am getting ready to stop begging saints and praying with saints and licking saints up and down and begging them to be saved. Hello, somebody. You have an order, or you have a mandate from God to be holy. You have a mandate from God to be saved. You have a mandate from God to be blessed. I want you to slap by with three people what happens when you don't follow his orders. In the book of Psalms 13, it looked like the Lord had me all up in Psalms today. In the book of Psalms chapter 13 and verse 15, oh my God. Is anybody getting anything out of this? I'm about to give you the charge in a minute. Oh, the emotion, come on. In the book of Psalms chapter 13 and verse number 15, look at what the word of God says. Oh my God. Amen. I guess it's verse 5. Oh, y'all don't hear me what I'm saying. Oh, I didn't get that one right. Amen. But what it says is that the way of a transgressor is hard. In other words, when God orders you to do something, you don't have a choice in the matter. When God orders you to come to church, you've got to get up and come. Because if you disobey his charge and you disobey his order, the Bible said the way of a transgressor, is one who steps over God's boundaries. A transgressor is one who transgresses God's law. God has commanded you to do something, and somehow or another, you've got the audacity, and you've got the balls. Hello, somebody. Yes, I said you got the balls to step over God's plan, and to step over God's correction, and to step over his structure. Hello, somebody.
Transgressing all the laws that God has set down here. And the Bible says the way of the trans.
We're going into a new dispensation. We're going into a place where Jesus is getting ready to either give us great miracles or great, great judgment. And I don't know about you, but I want to be in the place of great miracles. I want to get a great breakthrough. Somebody give me a witness in here. We're going into a new year. And all things are going to be passed away. And all things are about to become new. Somebody say yeah.
Praise the Lord. I know that you enjoyed this special Christmas broadcast. Amen. And we're going, it's for Christmas and New Year's. And I just want to make sure I tell all of our partners, have a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Today on the broadcast, we have one of our young people who is in our young people's department. And his name is Brother Kendrick. And real quick, Brother Kendrick, share with our audience how this ministry has been a blessing to your life.
This ministry been a blessing to my life because first I started off as a hood boy, and then I met this boy named Walter who introduced me to Pastor Ernest Johnson, and then Pastor Ernest Johnson told me that I couldn't be backsliding, I have to come forward with the Lord, and I shouldn't be backsliding because it's not good to backslide. You won't get no blessings if you backslide. So therefore, I'm here on the show to let everybody know that I'm being faithful and I'm with the Lord, and I'm happy that I met Pastor Ernest Johnson, and I love Jesus, and I just want all you out there to know that, and I want you to follow the right path and go where Jesus is the answer. And here go my pastor, Ernest Johnson.
Amen. Praise the Lord. We thank God for Brother Kendrick, and we thank God for each and every one of you joining the broadcast of Jesus is the Answer today. Our time is winding up. Amen. But I want to remind each and every one of you, if you need prayer, pick up our toll-free prayer line right now. There's a prayer counselor standing by to pray for you. Amen. Pick up the telephone. Call a prayer counselor. If you'd like to have a copy of this message in its entirety, that's an order. Amen. Tell the prayer counselor, I'd like to have that. Now, I want many of you to write us. The writing address is on your screen right now. I want you to write us, send us your most urgent prayer request, and tuck in that love gift to help keep television, help us take this gospel message to the whole wide world. Well, we thank God for Elder and Sister Butler and Praise Center. We thank God for the members of Jesus is the Answer. We thank God, and I say to you on behalf of all the saints, the partners, and friends of this great ministry, Merry Christmas, and have a Happy New Year, and no matter what your problems are, Jesus is the answer. God bless you, and we'll see you next time. Praise the Lord. This is Bishop Ernest Johnson, and I'm inviting you to join us this Sunday morning for an anointed Holy Ghost revival service at the Jesus is the Answer Apostolic Church in the World Television Center. We're located at 17208 South Figueroa Street in the heart of Gardena, California. Come on out and join us where the Feast of the Lord is going on. We'll see you there. Let's go!